Once again, welcome to Problems of Peristaltic Reaction 2. That's the topic I'm going to discuss right now. Okay, so I will discuss first on electrocyclic reaction. So they have given a substrate like this, COOMe, and there is CH2PH, and consecutive electrocycloaddition reaction. So that's the question. We have a substrate like this, and diphenyl acetylene, and what will be the product? So first, what I have to do? It will undergo a ring opening. What I'm saying? Ring opening, CH2PH, and see this two COOMe are this. So I am writing from a convenience as in the upper side COOMe both are this. So of course there will be hydrogen here. So first you have to consider how many electrons are there in this ring opening system. There are 2 and 1 sigma bond, so 4 pi electron system, 4 pi electron. And it is a thermal condition, so 4 pi thermal, it's a con-rotary rotation. So how will you remember this? You can do it in your own way, however you like. 4 pi thermal con-rotation, then of course 4 pi h nu d's rotation. Just do the opposite for 6 electron or 4n plus 2. 4n plus 2 thermal, it will be d's rotation, or 4n plus 2 h nu, it will be con rotation. You just remember this point. You can do easily any type of problem or question. So that's the basic funda. So here it is a 4 pi electron system, and so thermal, so it will be con rotation. Okay, so let me do the what will be the product in this case. So I am doing it like this. So and this, so what you get, I'm not doing again con rotation, dis rotation, just for the, so here will be a negative charge, and there will be a double bond, here will be CH2 plus, and there will be a plus, and there will be negative. And now the question is, where will be the my substituent? So till now that's okay, their nitrogen lone pair gets here and gets plus and minus. Now what about the COOMe and hydrogen? What I say, it's con rotation. You do just draw a line, just parallel to align with this. What I say, con rotation. Con rotation means rotation both in the same orientation, say both clockwise or both anti-clockwise, whatever may you wish, whatever you wish. So I am doing like this. So it will going anti-clockwise. So con rotation, it will also undergo anti-clockwise. So if I rotate this. See, this is my COOMe. Say, if I put it like this, COOMe will outside. So it will be here, COOMe. Of course, hydrogen will be there. And if I rotate this, COOMe will be inside this system. Not inside, but you can keep in mind, COOMe and hydrogen will be outside. So it's con rotation, that is both in the same clockwise and anti-clockwise. So I am rotating like this, COOMe in this way, in fashion. And if this, so COOMe in the inside. So this is our intermediate. I'm going to remove this. So now, so this is our system. And one more thing, we have to do a cycloaddition. What we have? We have this type of system, that is 2PH. So that's the problem. So what will happen now? It's a 1,3 dipolar cycloaddition. So it goes here and goes here, this. So now product will be, keep the thing as it is, nothing change, there is pH, there is pH, and of course there will be our COOMe and hydrogen, COOMe hydrogen, and it is as it is. Now the question is, what will be the stereochemistry? As I've already told that the both in diene and dienophile, the stereochemistry of the substrate is retained. Now see, one is outside of this, like you can easily imagine, and one is inside. So these are trans. So what will this will be? Also trans. COOMe is trans. Or in the else you can say hydrogens are, one is outside and one is inside. So these are trans. So if I like this, COOMe, so of course it will be like this hydrogen. What I said, it will be trans. So our system will be like this, COOMe, and it will be this. So that's the product of this question. Okay, So I hope it's clear to you. Then discuss the second question. The second question is little interesting. It's an again cycloaddition reaction. The question is that you have a diene in a fixed system, and what is the A, and they are given the product here. There is oxygen and there is oxygen, and what is B, they have questioned, and this is the system. So they have given four options. I am going to write those options so it will be easy how to handle this question. The first option, they have given O3 oxygen for A. This is A and this is B. Okay, and they have given here diamond N double bonded N C double O K and single bond C double O K. Second option, they have given oxygen H nu, and B is given the same thing. Okay, I'm not writing. Third option, they have given also H nu oxygen H nu rose Bengal. Sorry, I didn't write this rose Bengal. Here also there is rose Bengal, and they have given B as hydrogen palladium carbon. Okay, and fourth option, they have given oxygen, this case thermal, and of course rose Bengal, it is there, and hydrogen palladium carbon. So this is the question. They have asked what is A and what is B, the product and reactant, all is there. So before I discuss the question, you just look at this four option. I am going to little click. So you see this part. So there is oxygen bond one, and you see the four, and it is retained. What happened in this case? The double bond is just hydrogen is added here, that is reduction. So double bond is retained and just hydrogen. So you see hydrogen palladium carbon is there. So you may ask that it will reduce. Of course it will reduce, but the problem is there that it will undergo reductive cleavage. If we use this hydrogen palladium carbon, it will undergo reductive cleavage, that is this bond will break. So you can immediately, by seeing this, you can say that this is not the correct option. Why? Because it will reductively cleave this bond. Of course it will reduce, but it will cleave the bond. So that's why these two options you can easily cancel. So what we have left, of course, these two options. So what will be the answer of this term? Which one is the correct answer? It is also easy. Now the second problem is easy. You know that of course these two are same. So of course then this double bond is there, reduced here. So now ozone O3O2 or oxygen HNU rose Bengal. Of course we would not like to prefer ozone. Of course there is a double bond, so there will be probability of ozone rises and other things. So it will be not the question answer. So of course this is the answer of the question. I'm not doing anything, just seeing the option, what is the case, just analyze it, and you get the correct answer. So I have solved the question number two, and I will just show it how does it happen. In presence of oxygen and H nu, they have given a diene, and this is my dienophile in excited state template. So it will go like this and this. It's not just pericyclic, but I can show it for convenience. So this and this, and in presence of diimide, that is N double bonded N C double O K, here also C double O K. It just hydrogenate, that's the one hydrogen here and hydrogen here, it will give the our product. And this reagent will not cleave this oxygen-oxygen bond. So that's why we get this product. So that's the complete analysis of this question. So let me discuss the third question. The third question is sigmatropic rearrangement. It's a very good question actually. So they have given a system like this. So, and the reagent is here KHTHF H3O+. Okay, so what will be the product? That's the question. So before you I go to the product, I want to say one thing. You just count the double bond numbering. Say whatever you watch, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So what is there? 1, 5 diene. Okay, 1,5. There is a 1,5 diene system. And what we have? An alcohol OH group in this system. So it is 1,5 diene undergo 3,3 sigmatropic rearrangement. And one case is there, there is a OH and we have base. So you know, of course, it is general chemistry says that it will deprotonate this system. So 1,5 oxyanion, 3,3 oxyanionic sigmatropic. So I just 1,2,3,4,5. You just see the system, what is it? And OH base is there, 3,3 oxyanionic sigmatropic rearrangement. So how does it occur and what is the structure of this compound product? So I will show it in the pen. So first I am just deprotonating it. So it will be O minus. Then what you do? Just sigmatropic rearrangement. This one, this will go here, and this system will get here. You see the arrow where it is going. It's very important. So how to draw the product? Don't do anything. Just leave it as it is. So this bond is gets here. I did it. This bond has clipped, so there is no bond. Another thing, this bond has clipped, so it is nothing there. O minus is there. And there is a bond, it is, and one bond is more here, so there is a double bond, okay. And there more another bond, this single bond. Now it has been single bond. And from this, we have a bond like this here. So that's the system. Now you know that it will undergo interest of H3O plus. So I am writing this again. Okay. I am not doing anything here. Keto, single bond, one single bond more, and this has system like this. So what is the? It's look very difficult to write in this form. So it just simplify it. You can easily see there is a six-member ring, and how much it's? You just count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So it is like this, and here from there will be a bond, and from see one bond and two bond here, and from this 1, 2 you put two bond, 1, 2 there is a carbonyl, 1, 2, 1, 2 carbonyl, and how many are left? 1, 2 this is 1 and this is my 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 2 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So this is our product. So you just write it properly, do the arrow, show the arrow, and you will get the product. So that's it for today. Thank you for watching.